Hey, Magical Main Street Dad fans, we're back. I'm Nevin.
I'm Josh.
How you doing, Josh?
I'm doing good, man. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Big week this past week, lots of news, and we got it right here for you.
All right. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff that came out, and exciting things, I think. So.
Yeah, I think so. But first, I want to touch base on last week's episode with the annual pass. We have found out that the IncrediPass, or incredibly expensive pass, as I like to call it, the child price between 3 to 9 is the same as the adult price. Yeah.
Wow.
So, I thought it might have been a glitch, but kids and adults pay the same for the IncrediPass. I personally think that's ludicrous, but that's not me.
Yeah. The daily tickets are a little bit cheaper, you know, And when you're eating and you get the dining pass, it's a little bit cheaper for kids. They don't eat as much. Whatever. You want to pay it? Go ahead.
Yep. By all means.
Go ahead.
If you want. That's a lot of money, especially for me. So. All right. Anyway, let's talk in some, jump in some really good news this week.
All right. Some positives.
A little bit of news that caused the internet to have a huge meltdown. After 13 years, the Finding Nemo performance is ending. That was what came out. It's ending. The internet went crazy. I've seen the show. I liked it. It's a good show. It's definitely one of the must shows. I personally think Lion King is a better performance.
Yeah.
But I'd go see it again. I thought it was a really good show. After the internet went crazy the next day, Disney released a statement. While it is ending, in 2022, it's coming back, but it's a different show. So let's look at it here. This was based off a 2003 Pixar Disney movie, Finding Nemo. It was the exact thing. The movie was just reenacted. The movie came out in 2003. We're in 2020. Time for some change. And just to let you know, like I said, it ran for 13 years, from 2007 to 2020. Just to give you a little bit of reference, on Broadway, the show Mamma Mia ran for 14 years. Cats, one of the all-time best shows. Cats ran for 18 years. Now, yes, they ran a little bit longer, but the Finding Nemo show did more performances than both of them combined.
Wow.
In 18 years, Cats did 6,000 performances. Okay? They did two shows every couple days, where the Finding Nemo show did, I don't know, from 3 to 5 shows a day. And they held, that auditorium held close to 1,600 people at a time.
It's a lot of people and a lot of shows.
A lot of people, a lot of shows. I'm on board with the changing it. I'm on board.
I am too. And, you know, you can only rehash things for so long. And I think from what they're saying, it's still going to be Finding Nemo. They're going to update it. So maybe change a little bit here and there. I did read that they're keeping some of the songs that everybody likes in there. So you're going to have that. It's going to be familiar to you, but a little bit different.
Yeah.
And that's always the key thing, is to keep it fresh, but keep it comfortable.
Yep.
So that you're not going to totally hate it. I'm excited to see an update. I saw that once, and for me, that was enough. I think it's a great show. I think it's more for littler kids, maybe. Maybe not. Little kids sometimes do get scared of the puppets for some reason. I've seen plenty of kids freak out about the puppets. But
Bruce, they kind of feel freaky.
I mean, it is a great show. I personally don't think it's something I have to see every time I go.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, once every 2 years or something is cool for me. Because it was a rehash of the movie. Just pop the movie in.
Yeah.
But dads, if you need a break and your kids are just melting down and need to relax, you're out of the sun. It's a little bit cooler in there.
It's air conditioned. Take a nap. I think theater and the seating is better than the Lion King's.
Mm-hmm.
It's not bleacher seating. It's actually like park bench seating. So I think that aspect was better than Lion King's performance. But you're right. It's just a reenactment of the movie. That's all it is.
Yep. But talented performers. So.
Oh, yeah. And some of them were from Broadway. So yes. These are performers that are on that level of, you know, being on show. So the internet lost their mind with that one. The next day, like I said, Disney released the statement. We share the news as much as we can. Trust me, oh my God, all the crying faces and Disney is going crazy with it. And then the next day they released the statement of how they're just tweaking it and keeping it fresh.
I think they did that on purpose just to create a little...
Little drama there.
Yeah, drama on the internet. They knew they were going to continue it.
So, next, I personally have never seen this person, but he's been with Disney for 23 years, which is a long run. And I'm talking about Yeehaw Bob.
Nice.
He's returning starting October 14th. He's already been booked from October 14th, 15th, 17th, and 18th. He put on his personal Facebook page, do not go there to 17th. He has a commitment for another location that he agreed with. For those of you who don't know, Yeehaw Bob does a free performance at Port Orleans Riverside. It's kind of like a vaudeville performance and comedy act. I personally have never seen it. But he's got a cult following.
Yeah, he's pretty popular with a lot of Disney fans out there. And
performing.
When it was said that he was going to be let go, and as so many performers were at the beginning of the pandemic, it was understandable. And I think Nevin and I always said, like, we probably going to see these people come back at some point.
Yeah.
So you're going to start seeing these performers coming back, you know, so Yeehaw Bob's coming back, whether it's a limited engagement or it's going to progress. I think they're insane not to. And I think Bob would appreciate it if he gets to stay there. I'm sure it's good for him and it's good for the fans.
Yeah.
So I think we're going to see more and more of the street performers come back too, especially at Hollywood Studios. I love those characters that are driving around and stopping and talking to people. That was so much fun. More and more, we're going to see that come back. We always said that they would.
Yeah. Well, right now his schedule hasn't been fixed. It's just those dates.
Yeah.
But he said he's going to be back full time, just Disney. Just for reference, his shows used to be from 8:30 at night to 12 in the morning. And that was all the time at Port Orleans. So, and it shows you his versatility, because being there for 23 years.
Yeah.
That says something about him as a performer.
Absolutely.
Not to keep it, oh my God, it's the same thing every night. It's the same thing. I'm sure he does a good amount of the same songs, but I'm sure the jokes and everything has definitely got to be spiced up.
Yeah, he's going to interact too. And, you know, if he sees something, you know, he's a performer. He's going to feed off the energy of the crowd like performers do. Whether you're a comedian or a musician, you feed off the crowd. So good deal. I like that.
Yeah, I was happy about that. The next bit of news. I'm going to say, for me, this would not fit for me.
Okay.
They announced that the dessert parties at Magic Kingdom are returning. The dessert parties are ticketed events, means you have to pay extra. All it is it's a dessert party where the food is provided and it's desserts. Now, granted, it's Disney cooks and pastry chefs, so the food is going to be great. We already know that. That's hands down, that's going to be great. But you get at the Tomorrowland Terrace, you got seating for the fireworks show, which I personally think you're kind of off to the side. I don't like that view, but that's me. It's a ticketed event. So for me, as an adult, it's $114. A child is $69, and a child is 3 to 9. That's a freaking cupcake, in my opinion.
Yeah, how many cupcakes do you get for $114?
It's all you can eat buffet.
I don't know. I could eat 2, 3.
Yeah, if that. Those things are huge.
Yeah, they are. You eat just one? That's one expensive cupcake.
It is. And for me, that's a lot. I mean, yeah, we've talked about keeping the energy levels, you know, making sure you stop and give some sugar and things like that. That's a little late in the night for me to be giving the kids that much sugar.
Yeah. Now, if they made it like cocktails and maybe some beer and some pretzels, I'd be all about that.
Okay. The Epcot Frozen Ever After did have adult drinks, and the one at Animal Kingdom had adult drinks. This one does not. I think, me personally, I think they should have the princesses there doing a meet and greet, or some characters as well.
Yeah.
Obviously, now with COVID, they can't really do that. But I mean, you know what I mean? Something a little extra than just the cupcakes, and you got a seat off to the side for the fireworks. Again, that's me. That doesn't. I just don't see it.
You know, you can go down on Main Street, get a cupcake for like $5, and go watch the fireworks anywhere, and yeah, save yourself $109.
Exactly. But I know some people will swear by it. I know when Frozen Ever After first came out, they had it where you also got a fat, as soon as the show was over, Illuminations was over, you walked on to Frozen Ever After the ride, which made it a little better, because remember, at that time, the wait was almost 4 hours.
Right.
You didn't have to worry about getting a fast pass or nothing like that. After Illumination, you walked on the ride. Okay, you gave me a little extra there. Do I think that would have been worth $114? I don't know. The cocktails looked pretty good, though. I will say that.
I don't know, man. I'm just anti things like that. Because I personally like to spend my money on other things. So I'm a merchandise kind of guy. I'm a collector. So to me, that's a fleeting moment.
Yeah, I agree.
But you want to do it, it's there for you.
Yeah, exactly. It's coming back. And that starts in, of course, October.
Of course.
For the 50th. So check. Make sure your park reservations, check for availability, because it's not going to be every night, obviously, because it's a ticketed event. A company would have to, like, have their chefs and all that there. So if nobody's booked for that night, why would you waste your money on that? You know what I mean? So make sure you check for availability and if the party is actually happening. So moving on to my last bit of news, one that I do like. I've seen it many times, not live. I've seen it many times. It's the Epcot Candlelight Processional Performance at Christmas. For those of you who don't know what this is, it is a show with an orchestra. And it's pretty much the entire Christmas story. It's narrated sometimes by huge celebrities. Neil Patrick Harris loves narrating it. He's a top one. Gary Sinise has done it. Whoopi Goldberg's done it. I'm talking top tier performers and actors have narrated this. Again, it's just like it's the Christmas story. And it's very hard to get into it. You can buy, and the dining packages that include this are not out yet, so there's no pricing yet. Normally, you get a reservation at a specific place to eat. You also get a ticket for that show and a reserved seat. I will tell you this, people who do not get those reserved seats will start lining up around 2 o'clock in the afternoon outside the Americans Pavilion, because right there, that amphitheater is where they do it, just to try and get a seat. They used to do three shows a night. It used to be 5, 6:45, and 8:15. They did not say if they're going to be doing three shows a night again. The narrators are not, that information hasn't come out yet either. They just said they're bringing it back. I personally love the show. I think it's a great show. It's a great way to tell the Christmas story. Great way to get it in, get your family into the holiday spirit and things like that. So I'm pretty psyched about that.
Cool. See, they're bringing the things back. They're bringing back the things that you missed. Yeah. So those of you who said the magic was taken away, they're starting to bring this back. And hopefully you can find your magic again.
like we said, Disney was always up front with it.
Yeah, they were.
The only people who could take the magic away is you.
Pretty much.
I personally really do hope they bring back the gingerbread houses at the resorts for the holidays. And I would love to see the, oh my God, now I just had a brain fart. Forgot. The Grand Floridian Orchestra. I really hope they bring that band back. Because when I went there with my daughter, when I was stationed in Tampa at the holidays, we went to all the resorts to see the gingerbread houses. The last one was the Grand Floridian, because the gingerbread house is huge. You just had that Victorian feel. You smelled the gingerbread in the air, and then you heard the orchestra playing Christmas music. Great way to get you into the Christmas spirit. So I really, really hope they bring back that group.
Yeah, I do too. Like I said, they're going to bring it all back eventually.
We knew they would. It's just going to take time.
Yeah. They will. Definitely. Good news. I like upbeat, happy news.
Yeah, it's a lot of happy news. Nothing.
We've been down so recently with the news. So
I think what's been downing us is the fact that we lost so much. The prices came out. We were like, ugh. But now it's like, okay, we're hamping up for the 50th. We got Halloween, you know, according to Disney, they're on full Halloween mode.
Right.
September. And we got Christmas right around the corner.
Don't say that already.
We got Christmas right around the corner. So you got the holidays coming up. So Disney at Christmas time is amazing. I've been there. The park is absolutely beautiful. You'll never catch me close to the holidays down there. Mm-hmm. Way too many people. If you want to see the Disney holidays and get great photo ops, I would say between November 5th and the 14th is a perfect window. It's dead and all the lights are on. So.
Good deal.
Yeah.
Good deal. I just want to say, moving into the 50th, okay, coming up, people were complaining about extra hours being taken away. So for the 50th, we're talking October 1st and 2nd, and some parks September 29th. You're going to get a little bit extra time. Not much, but they're giving you an hour to an hour and a half at some parks. So Magic Kingdom on the 29th, and then October 1st and 2nd, you're going to be able to stay an hour later. So it's 8 to 10 instead of 8 to 9. So it's an extra hour. That's for everybody. Epcot is going to open an hour earlier.
Nice.
So instead of 11, it's at 10. I mean, I'm sorry, instead of 10, it's at 9. So it's 9 to 10 p.m. there. And then, surprisingly, Animal Kingdom is giving you an extra hour and a half. So it's 8 a.m. to 8:30 p.m. instead of 7, which they normally always closed early because of the animals and everything. Yep. But last time I was there a couple years ago, almost 5 years now because of the stupid pandemic, but they were all open a little bit later because of Rivers of Light.
Yep.
And that was a great show. I enjoyed that. So again, you know, they're bringing these things back for you. So I think that's a very positive thing. Extra hours were an hour or two anyway. So I think that's great. If you're going on Rise of the Resistance, this is a 50-50 split on if this is good or not. But starting September 23rd, no more virtual queue.
Yep.
So you don't have to sit there on your phone and try to, oh, I missed it, and then try again later at 1 o'clock. However, you could be waiting 2 to 3 hours in line. But with the GD Plus coming out, is this a way for Disney to say, well, just buy the Lightning Pass and you can go quicker than wait in line for 2 to 3 hours? So some people are excited because you don't have to worry about getting a boarding pass. Some people are saying, well, now it's going to force me to buy a pass because I don't want to wait 2, 3, 4, 5 hours. Well, that's your prerogative. You want to pay the money. Whatever it is, we'll see how it works out. It might even help with crowd control for other rides. So let's see how it works out. It might not be that bad. Don't know.
Well, if you think about it, the virtual queue, you were just holding your spot virtually in line. Now they got rid of that. Okay, now you actually physically have to be in line.
Right. But the good thing about the virtual queue is you could go do something else.
Right, exactly.
Which,
I mean, I'm glad to see the virtual queue going away because we all know you have X amount of people at Disney, at the resort. The Wi-Fi is not the strongest because of everybody. So, you know, I mean, some people were getting missed out on it because of the slow internet. Now you physically have to be there and get it done. So I think it opens up the playing field to more even.
I think it does. It's more traditional
way
of doing it. So let's see how it works out before we go and poo-poo it or praise it.
I like the virtual queues are nice because you can do other things, like I said. But I like the traditional because of how slow the internet is at the resorts. And it's not because Disney's giving you a slow internet. It's just how many people are on the internet at the same time. Right. You know, everybody wants to go live, send pictures, get on the internet. Then you got to try and get in that virtual queue. And like Josh said, you're like, I missed it. Yeah. Now, I have the choice. Wait in line or I'll spend the money for the.
I'll tell you now, as much as I hate to do it, I'm paying. I'm not waiting.
I would.
I would just budget it. I know I got three people and whatever it is. If it's $20 a person, it's $20. I look at it. Okay, it's $60. Kind of think of it as like a souvenir. I need to go on the ride. I'm not going to waste 3 hours waiting in line when I could be going doing something else. So I don't wait that long in lines. I refuse.
No, I refuse as well. And it's just for that fact. I spent $100+ to get into the park. If I'm wasting 3.5 hours to 4 hours, that's almost half the day gone.
Yeah.
I'll spend the $60, get me on the ride. I'm off the ride. I can do a lot more now.
Exactly.
Like you said, a lot of people may not feel that way. They're just going to stay in line. Fine. That means less line at Tower of Terror.
Yeah. You know? Exactly. Exactly. And I just have one more piece of news that I think is fantastic. It made me happy when I saw it this week because Nevin and I are animal lovers and we love Animal Kingdom.
Yes, we do.
Recently, they just had a birth of a white rhino baby. And White rhino is an endangered species. There's only 18,000 left in the world. Only two reside in North Africa. The rest reside in the southern part of the continent. But it's a great, great thing. Disney does so much with the endangered species and trying to breed. And you think, well, it's at Disney, it's a zoo, it's this. No, it's still another member of this species being introduced into the world. And, you know, it might be sad that one day the only place we're going to see some of these animals is a place like Kilimanjaro Safari.
Yeah.
So they do a great job. I love their animal conservation and what they do. So this is fantastic news. And it's something like the fourth baby born this year of like significance. Now, they're all significant, but you know, they had a gorilla, they had a hippo. So, hey, it's great news. Yeah. I just want to end my news on that point because I like rhinos. They're awesome.
Yeah, I agree. It's great. It doesn't matter that they're at Disney. You know what I mean? Like Josh said, they're an endangered species. Anything we can do, since humans are the reason why they're endangered, anything we can do to protect these majestic animals, to help them, is, I'm all for it.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're not trapped in a cage and prodded and things like that. Yes, they're in cages in the evening to protect themselves, but then the rest of the day they're out doing exactly what they would do in Africa.
Exactly.
So,
eat, poop, whatever.
So yes, that's huge news. Great way to end the show. So Josh, you got anything else?
That's it, man. Can't top the baby white rhino.
Nah, I can't top that. No, you can't. So with that, guys, keep an eye out on Instagram and Facebook, Magical Main Street Dads. We're the only ones there. I may be going live. Now, this is Saturday, so I may be going live. Well, you guys were racing it if I went live. But just keep an eye out because we always
go live. You have to. Now you have to.
Oh, I know. I have to make a run to the mall, so I'm going to swing by the Disney store.
All right.
I'm going to be live later today on Saturday, so it'll be past tense for you, for us watching. But at Twitter, at Magic Main ST Dads. And then, of course, here on YouTube, ring the bell, hit that notification, like, subscribe. Always, always, always leave us comments, guys, what you think. If you'd like to see more upbeat news and us sharing the news, or if you'd like to say, hey, you know, let's go a little bit more in depth on the dessert parties. I'm interested in it. We can dig and get that information for you as much as I think it's a little paid out of the pocket for that. But that's just me. I'm a cheap guy, but I want five lightsabers, so I got to save up.
You and me both, man.
So with that, we're off. Thanks for watching. Have a great day and be safe.
See ya.
Even though the sound of it is something my control, if you say it loud enough, I'll be shouting. Go, Super! Tumble over. Oh, who's the leader of the madness made for you?